There are already existing a management district, a business association, property owners and residents group, a citizens group. Depending on the issue, a lot of these groups find themselves at odds. The advocates say that's where they will make a difference. Some say it's both the city's most coveted and controversial neighborhood, with issues often making headlines that pit businesses against residents and tourists against locals. At times, the French Quarter is a neighborhood divided, something the French Quarter advocates want to change.
Not just the interests of a few, or perhaps led by a small group of people who aren't listening to their constituents.
Michael Wilkinson lives, works, and owns a business in the French Quarter. He believes any effort to bring different factions together is a step in the right direction, even though there are already about a half dozen business or neighborhood groups. Organizers say this one fills an important void.
We feel like that we needed a better voice, you know, with our city government and with our councilwoman, things that, you know, we don't feel like was getting out there from the aspect of a neighborhood.
And the issues are vast. Last month, a string of armed robberies in the French Quarter. Last week, several reports of sexual assault, ongoing quality of life challenges like noise and development. How do the new groups step up to meet those challenges without ruffling any feathers?
We think that people really want sensible, workable solutions for the problems that we deal with in the French Quarter on a day-to-day basis. But the existing neighborhood groups have been a voice of divisiveness and dissent and controversy, and we feel that if you can approach solutions in a spirit of teamwork, camaraderie.
So, in the city's oldest neighborhood, this group says it's trying to take a new approach to solving problems, because what happens in the French Quarter affects the rest of the city.
The French Quarter is the bread and butter of New Orleans, actually of the state of Louisiana. Without it, who's coming to New Orleans?
Now, some of the people gathered tonight tell us they just came out because they were curious. There were even a few skeptics at the meeting, just wondering how it will all work. It's a wait-and-see approach at this point, but membership is open to anyone who cares about the Quarter and wants to make it a better place. Scott.
Gina, thanks. French Quarter advocates say they want to focus on improving infrastructure in the Quarter and public safety, as well as holding fundraisers to help pay for